Hi everybody, this is an updated video of how to create your second bar graph for the Darwin's Bean Dip file. So if you're in your file and you're scrolling down the part two data analysis and discussion questions here, we're actually on number two. There is a link here, but this is actually based off of some of the features of Google Chrome last year and frankly some of the features that we had not had set up in last year's spreadsheet. So this updated video will make it a lot faster and a lot easier for you. So again, we are on number two. We're creating a bar graph based on the number of beans collected for each round. So one of the things you need to do is you need to go to the spreadsheet, which has all of the data that you guys have been entering over the last 3 days and the last 10 rounds. And if you'll notice, there's several tabs at the bottom. If you are doing them in order, you've already done the appendage summary by watching Mr. Stahl's video. So now you're going to be creating the bean summary. And this is kind of our final product, but we'll get rid of that and I'll show you how we make it. So what you're going to do is you're first going to highlight just the data that we have in fact collected, and we did 10 rounds, quite a bit of data and quite a bit of beans have been picked up. Once you have this highlighted, you are going to insert a chart, and you can do it one of two ways. You can go to the menu at the top of the toolbar and click insert chart, or if you go over here to the right hand side where your toolbar is, it says insert chart. So you click on that. Now, Google and Chrome and Sheets have gotten a lot savvier. So based on the data that we collated for you, it's already determined that we probably want a bar graph. And they call it a column chart, but obviously here we know we call it a bar graph. But there's still a couple of things that need to be adjusted. So one of the first things you'll need to adjust, or just double check really, is your chart type. We are going to keep it as a column chart, so that's pretty easy, but you want to be sure that these two items are checked off. You want the first row to be the header, and you want the first column to be the label, okay? Next thing we need to do is the customization. This title is not going to cut it. So first of all, you do want to call it a figure number, and this is your second bar graph, so it'll be figure two. I don't really need it to be this long. So it's the total number of beans collected really for all bean dippers, right? And that suffices as a title. From there, everything else is really pretty good shape. Google's figured out pretty much what we're looking for. So we're going to click the insert button. Okay, now when you do, you might notice that some of these labels are cut off. I can see that the blue bars are the total number of beans collected for straw, but not strawis. And the orange ones, I can't even tell at all what they are. So I'm going to just expand that a little bit. Now I can see that it says forecus, so that's great. I can copy this now that I have all of them properly labeled. Hit copy chart, go back to my bean dip file. I'm going to paste it in because this is supposed to be after number two. Control V, or you can do the insert paste function, and there is my chart. So I've got my second bar graph all done and complete.